this time, but certainly we recognize the decision Moses had made. We're grateful that the elders of this congregation have placed their confidence in him to do this work. But it's also important that each of us here, in particular Moses, understand the work of an evangelist. The Apostle Paul wrote to Timothy in 2 Timothy, to do the work of an evangelist, to fulfill your ministry. And so we need to understand what that work is and what an evangelist does to a certain extent. There's so much that we can't extend all of the information the Bible has to say, but I hope what we share tonight will be helpful to all of us here, in particular for Moses and his family. The evangelist or the preacher performs so many important and biblical functions within the body of Christ. He's a messenger of God to warn, encourage, and instruct the people of God. He's a proclaimer of the gospel of Jesus Christ in a lost and dying world. He's a leader, but he's not the leader in the local church. He's a leader in the local church. He works alongside of the elders, according to Ephesians chapter 4, to equip the church for works of service. He's an authority, but he's not the authority. Rather, he has authority as long as he preaches the word of God. So Moses, do the work of an evangelist. The nature of the evangelist's work is shared with us in 2 Timothy chapter 2. And I'd like you to turn there if you have your scriptures tonight. 2 Timothy chapter 2, in the first 7 verses, the Bible says, "You therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. The things which you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust these to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. Suffer hardship with me as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No soldier in active service entangles himself in the affairs of everyday life so that he may please the one who enlisted him as a soldier. Also, if anyone competes as an athlete, he does not win the prize unless he competes according to the rules. The hardworking farmer ought to do his work first and receive his share of the crops. Consider what I say, for the Lord will give you understanding in everything." Moses, do the work of an evangelist. The business of the gospel requires reliable men who can endure hardship. An evangelist must endure in the face of opposition, sometimes rejection, and sometimes injustice. A preacher understands the work involves times of ill treatment by those that you're actually entrusted to care for. We might receive ill treatment in the church. In these times, there's a simple thing we say: man up. Rejoice that you're considered worthy to suffer dishonor for the name of Christ, if it should arise. Work hard, endure, and look forward to your prize. In verse 15 of that same chapter, the scripture says, "Be diligent to present yourself approved to God as a workman who does not need to be ashamed, accurately handling the word of truth." The evangelist does not change. He does not distort or manipulate the Bible to his liking. He does not preach to itch ears. He will prayerfully study. He will exegete the scriptures. He will confidently preach, and he will teach the gospel of Jesus Christ as is recorded in God's Bible. In verses 22 and 23 of chapter 2, it says, "Now flee from youthful lusts and pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace with those who call on the Lord from a pure heart. But refuse foolish and ignorant speculations, knowing that they produce quarrels." And so the evangelist's heart and mind seeks to be in tune with the mind of God. He will seek to lead a godly life. He will seek to be in harmony with all of God's church and love those that might even seek to harm him. The preacher is not to get caught up in foolish controversies, empty discussions, gossip, or petty differences. Evangelists are self-controlled men who are more concerned with the opinions of God than with the opinions of people. And that leads us to verses 24 and 25. It says, "The Lord's bondservant must not be quarrelsome, but be kind to all, able to teach, patient when wronged, with gentleness correcting those who are in opposition, if perhaps God might grant them repentance, leading to the knowledge of the truth." And so the preacher must be gentle in order to teach what is right. He must be easy to speak to, willing to accept criticism, and open to purposeful change. He's not to be irritable, intolerant, sarcastic, or scornful. Rather, like Christ, he seeks to be meek. And as we know, that meekness does not equal weakness. He's teachable, but he's also willing to teach with love and patience. And so in these areas, Moses did the work of an evangelist. And I believe Moses will excel in these areas as an evangelist. I think all who know Moses would say, it's hard to do these things for close friends and family. Moses is an example for all in the Lord's church and those outside the church as well. I think God is looking for good men who love their wives, who lead their families, serve their communities, who work hard and seek to evangelize the lost. The men God desires to serve in his church care about God's people. They care about protecting their hearts and their souls. Moses Hamilton is such a man. His family is well respected in the church and in the community. Moses is spiritually mature. He's biblically sound and kingdom minded. He will serve well alongside of the elders. He will serve well with the deacons and others in roles of ministry at Rocky Fork. And he will love and serve all who attend. He will help to lead the church in a positive direction for many years. And I believe Rocky Fork is destined for great things through the glory of God as Moses starts that work.
Amen.
Moses has been tested in life. He's been tested in the church. And I believe he's ready to accept this mantle of responsibility as an evangelist in the Lord's church with all my heart. God has always provided for Moses' family. I remember when he was laid off from a good paying job. Lost his benefits, but I watched as he trusted the Lord and maintained his integrity throughout. He's continued to keep the Lord first in everything, especially in his family. Moses is a proven servant. He served in the church here at Millwood as an elder, youth director, deacon, Sunday school director, Bible league coach, camp counselor, Sunday school teacher, oftentimes all at once. He's taught countless Bible studies and Sunday school lessons, and now, as an evangelist, preaching week after week and evangelizing day after day, doing studies in people's homes and evangelizing those in your community and discipling those within the church, we see a man who I believe is well prepared. He's willing to grow, yet he's gentle in spirit, and that goes a long way. I think what we see in Moses could be summed up very simply. He's a lover of God and a lover of people. Moses, please stand and come this way. Give Moses an opportunity to share some thoughts, but before we do, based on the word of God, I solemnly charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus and of these people. God is the judge of the living and the dead, and by his appearing in his kingdom, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with great patience and instruction. For the time will come when people will not endure sound doctrine. They will want to have their ears tickled. They will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance to their own desires. And they will turn away their ears from the truth and will turn aside to myths. But you, the Bible says, but you, be sober in all things. Endure hardship. Do the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry.